I mean, if you are an atheist, I guess you are. I don't know whether you call yourself that.
No, I don't call myself an atheist because it's not. No, I least of all do I call myself an agnostic. I mean, agnostic has the connotations of hedging one's bets. And atheist seems scarcely worth having a name for not believing in God any more than I have a name for not believing in witches. I'm not an ahexist. It's just that it's never occurred to me that there might be a God, or that there might be this immaterial entity called the soul. I don't know what happens when we die. Well, I think I do know. We just simply stop being. But I don't think anything makes an exit at that moment. And these curious euphemistic terms that are used, he's passed away, make it sound as if, in fact, death coincides with something that makes an exit from the body and goes elsewhere. I don't think that.
You can't not have occurred to you that there might be something called the soul or God.
Because yeah, no, it never.
Very clever people spent ages thinking about
it. Well, it never occurred to me, and I could never understand why people who quite clearly in many respects were very clever could actually sustain such an idea. It wasn't that it was wrong, but it was incoherent. The idea of a disembodied person makes no sense at all, any more than the idea of a circular rectangle makes sense. You can utter the phrase, but it doesn't mean that it's meaningful.
Wittgenstein's influence.
Yes, I suppose. No, but Wittgenstein gave me the lingo with which to talk that way. But I don't think I ever thought about it very hard. I suppose that I was puzzled by what was the difference between something that was lively, in the same way as I'd been preoccupied with looking at paramecium down the microscope.